Good morning, dear friends. Welcome to Rudraba Online Classes. Dear friends, in last class, we have completed exercise 8.5. Now, I am going to start the next one, that is the percentage. Percentages, that is another way of comparing quantities. Dear friends, you observe these two figures here. Dear friends, you observe here these two figures here. See, percentages we are using to comparing two quantities also. You observe these two pictures here. Here, one is Harita report. She got total
320 out of 400.
And total percent is 80%. And see, another figure here. In this figure, Harita's report. She also taken total marks overtime here 300 marks out of 360 marks. Here total percentage is 83.3%. Okay. Yes, friend. By comparing these two percentages, do you know which is very high percentage? What do you think about these two reports? Here, first report, here 320 out of 400, and here second report 300 marks out of 360 marks. See, here one is percentage 80% and second one is 83.3%. Do you know which is the more percentage here? See, out of 400, here she got here 320 marks, and out of 360, here she getting here 300 marks. Do you know which is more percentage here? Dear student, Harita percentage here 80 and Rita percentage was 83.3%. Here Rita percentage is more than Harita percentage. Dear student, do you agree this percentage? Dear student, percentage are numerator of the fraction with denominator 100. And have been used to comparing results. Let us try to understand with the details these percentages. Dear friend, first point I am taking here, meaning of percentage. Dear friend, do you know what is the meaning of percentage? Percentage, this is one of the Latin word. Percentum, percentum mean per hundred. What you will call percentage. Percentage mean per hundred. That is you will call percentage. Okay. Dear friend, percentage is represented by symbol. This is the percentage symbol. See, 1% out of 100. It can be written as, see here, this is the 1%. 1% out of 100. And it is written as 1 out of 100, and we can write 0.01%. Okay, this is the percent. Dear friend, for better understanding, you see this table here. Okay, here we have color yellow, green, red, blue. Okay, number of tiles here. Total we have 100 tiles. Rate per 100. Here yellow is 14, green is 26, and red is 35, and blue is 25. Now, when we are writing as a fraction, see, we are writing here 14 out of 100, 26 out of 100, and 35 out of 100, and 25 out of 100. Okay. We can written as in the form of percentage, that is the 14%, 26%, and 35%, and 25%, and 25%. Dear student, this is when we have total denominator is 100. Okay. This is the percentage when the total is 100. Okay, next you see second figure here. See, if percentages when total is not 100. You observe this table here. Here, given here, color red, blue. Total is 20. Total is 20. See, number of beads 8, 12. When we add these two, we are getting here 20. When we write it as a fraction, 8 by 20 and 12 by 20. Dear friend, here denominator, we have 20. We have to convert this denominator as a 100. So we have to multiply numerator and denominator by 100. When we multiply, we are getting here 800 by 2000. 800 by, see, when we divide it, when we cancel it, see, 800 by 2000. When we cancel in here, 240s are 800, 200s are here, 2000 completely cancelling here. See, we got here out of 140. 40 is, we got here, 40 is out of 100. Now, when we write it as a percentage, we are getting here 40%. Okay, dear friend, when we have total is not 100, in that moment we have to multiply numerator and denominator by 100. After converting as a denominator 100, we have to find the percentage. Okay, see, this is the math. Okay, dear friend, next point I am taking here, converting fractional numbers into percentage. See, let us see an example here. Write 1 by 3 as percent. That's percent. Solution. Here we have fraction. We have to convert as a percent. Now, see, we have 1 by 3. When we multiply by 100, we are getting here 100 by 3. You should see. By simple, when we divide it, 3 are 9, remaining 1 here 0. Again, 3 are 9, remaining 1. See, when we give the point, again we are getting here 3 are 9. Here, remaining 1. When we write it as a mixed fraction, we are getting here 3/3 whole 1 by 3%. This is the converting from the fraction as a percentage. Okay, dear friend, let us see another one example here. Example 2. Example. Out of 25 children, children's In a class, 15 girls, 25 children in a class, 15 are girls. We have to find out here percentage of girls. Now, see here, we know here given here out of 25 children in a class. Given here out of 25 children in a class, 15 are girls. Therefore, percentage of percentage of girls 15 by 25 into 100. 21s are 24s are. When we multiply here 15 into 4, 60% girls out of 25 children in a class. Okay, this is the solution. Okay, next example here. Next, third example. Convert 5 by 4 to percent. Percent solution. See, here we have fraction. We have to convert as a fraction. Percentage. Now, given here 5 by 4 into 100. See here, 4 ones are, 4 twos are, 8 remaining, 24 fives are. Okay, when we multiply here 5 into 25, we are getting here 125%. Okay, this is the converting percentage from the fraction 5 by 4. This is the solution. Okay, dear friend, next point I am taking here, converting decimal to percentage. If we have any decimal numbers, how we can convert as a percentage? See, let us see an example here. Converting decimal to percentage. Convert the given decimal to percent. Okay, so here we have 0.75 and second one 0.09. Let us see solution. Dear friend, here we have decimal numbers. We have to convert as a percentage. See, first one solution here. Here we have after decimal point, we have two numbers. So, first we have to write as a fraction to remove the decimal point. See, here we have after decimal point, we have two numbers. So, we have to divide by, we have to write as a fraction 75 by 100. We have to multiply by 100 to convert as a percentage. Now 100 will be cancelled here, remaining is 75%. Okay, this is the solution. Okay, next second one solution. See, here we have after decimal point we have two numbers, so we have to take as a denominator and write to remove the decimal point. See here, given here 0.09, when we removing decimal point, we are getting here 9 by 100 because we have two digits after decimal point. So I am taking here 100. Now, when we convert it as a fraction to decimal or multiply by 100, now see 100 will be cancelled. Here percentage is 9%. This is the method converting decimal number to percentage. Okay, here's right. Next point I am taking here, converting percentage to fraction or decimal numbers. Let us see an example here. Converting percentage to fraction or decimal form. Now I am giving here one example here. 1% and second one 10%. See, we have here 2%. We have 2%. We have to convert to form of fraction and to form of decimal. So see here, when we convert in any percentage to form of fraction or decimal, we have to write first step in the form of fraction. Now here 1% means out of 100. Now we can write here solution. When we write it as a fraction, we are writing here 1 by 100 because out of 100 here 1 part, here 1%. Now, when we are writing as a decimal point, see here, we have 20. So, we have to shift the decimal point before 2 digit. Now, when we are writing as a decimal point, we are writing here 0.01. This is the decimal number and this is the fraction. Next, second one here, solution. See, when we are writing as a fraction, we are writing here 10/100. Because out of 100 here, 10%, 10 part. Now, when we write it as a decimal number, see, we have 20. We have to shift here decimal point before two numbers. When we shift decimal point before two numbers, we are getting here 0.1. This is the decimal number. Okay, this is the method to convert in percentage to fraction or decimal. Okay, dear friend, next point. Dear friend, we know parts always add to whole. You adjust this table and you complete this table, you convert from the percentage to fraction and decimal. Okay, dear friend, next point I am taking here. Fun with estimation. Dear friend, I am taking here an example here. What percent? What percent of the adjoining figure is shaded? Now see here, you observe this picture. Yes, right. To find out here percentage of adjoint figure is shaded, we have to find out here first shaded part. Now let us see solution. We first find the fraction of the figure that is shaded. From the fraction, the percentage of shaded figure is found. Now have finding here half of the figure. 1/2 here in this figure shaded part is half part. Now 1/2. When we multiply by 100 to convert as a percentage, see here 2 1s are 250s are here 50%. Figure here shaded. Okay, dear.